Subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update from Seville's Daily.
Hello champions, welcome to the orientation lecture of our Decimate prelims program. So as you all know that prelims, even though it's a qualifying paper, it is a very important component of your UPSC exam cycle, because even though it's qualifying, majority of people get eliminated in this round. 99% of the people who give the UPSC prelims exam get eliminated in the prelims round itself. And with mains, we can be very sure that if you have good knowledge, if you have good answer writing ability, you will sail through. With prelims, it's not as easy as it seems, because a large number of very serious aspirants get eliminated in the prelims round itself. And we have examples of many people who were unable to clear prelims for the first 3 or 4 attempts, and when they cleared prelims, they got very good ranks. So it means that prelims exam itself is very tricky and dicey. Even if you see 2016, the topper of 2016, Tina Dubby, who scored very high in mains, she struggled to score good marks in the prelims exam. So when we talk of UPSC prelims exam, well, it has evolved over the years. 2010 and 11, it was more factual in nature, it was more based on trivia and facts. From 2012, the pattern of UPSC prelims changed, and you had more analytical type of questions which became the part of the prelims exam. Again, the pattern shifted from 2015, because till 2013-14, the nature of the paper was more analytical, there was hardly any current affairs in that. From 2015, the pattern of the paper had shifted, and we moved towards more current oriented paper. So since 2015, at least 40% of the prelims paper is based on current affairs, which reflects the importance of current affair in the exam. So let us just see very briefly, how has IAS prelims paper evolved in last 4-5 years. So let's start with 2015 prelims paper. So in this year's paper, the emphasis was both on the traditional part and the current affairs part, and you required a combination of logical ability to solve the current affairs part. So let's take an example. So the example was, which one of the following national park has a climate that varies from tropical to subtropical? A, Kanchenjunga National Park. B, Nanda Devi National Park. C, Neora Valley National Park. D, Namdhapa National Park. Also, in this year, this question was asked, with reference to the art and archaeological history of India, which one among the following was made earliest? Lingaraj Temple at Bhubaneswar, Rock Cut Elephant at Dholi, Rock Cut Monuments at Mahabalipuram, Varaha Image at Udaygiri. So the questions were not as simple, they were not as direct as it was. Let's now come to 2016. 2016 was the most easiest prelims paper. The questions were mostly one-liners, and that was a shift in the pattern, because earlier most of the questions which were asked in UPSC prelims paper were generally statement based, but this year a large number of questions were direct, very factual and one-liners. For example, there was a question asked, the term regional comprehensive economic partnership often appears in the news in the context of the affair of a group of countries known as A, G20, B, ASEAN, C, SCO, D, SAARC. Now it's direct, and so you don't need to think. If you know the answer, you will do it. If you don't know the answer, you will not be able to do it. Then there was a question asked on, recently for the first time in our country, which of the following states has declared a particular butterfly as a state butterfly? A, Arunachal Pradesh. B, Himachal Pradesh. C, Karnataka. D, Maharashtra. So PCS type ke kuch questions we saw in 2016. Let's now come to 2017. 2017, the paper, I mean, it was a polity-based paper. There were 20 to 25 questions asked from pure polity. And the questions of polity were not very direct. It was more logical, and you need to clear your basics. Usse pehle, if your basics are not clear, you will not be able to clear, or you will not be able to solve those questions, even if you have read Lakshmikant. For example, there was this question asked, which one of the following statement is correct? A. Rights are the claim of state against the citizens. B. Rights are privileges which are incorporated in the constitution of the state. C. Rights are claims of a citizen against the state. D. Rights are privileges of a few citizens against the many. Let's now come to 2018 paper. 2018 was perhaps the toughest paper in last 5 years, because the current affairs questions which were asked were very indirect, and the factual component was also very high. And when you prepare for UPSC prelims, we tend to ignore the factual part, because we used to believe that factual questions are usually asked in the state exams, and in UPSC it's more about logical, more about analytical. But 2018 paper bucked that trend, because there were a lot of questions which were asked from a very factual part. And if we see the history questions, they were more logical in nature rather than asking just for the facts. They were more logical in nature. For example, there was a question asked on the staple commodities of export by the English East India Company from Bengal in the middle of the 18th century were A. Raw cotton, oil seeds and opium. B. Sugar, salt, zinc and lead. C. Copper, silver, gold, spices and tea. D. Cotton, silk, saltpeter and opium. So it was a history question, but it also had elements of geography in it. And if you can think logically, you can easily do it, but you have to think. If you have just mugged up the book, you will not be able to solve this question. And also there was a question asked on polity, which said, which one of the following reflect the most appropriate relationship between law and liberty? So A, if there are more laws, there is less liberty. B, if there are no laws, there is no liberty. C, if there is liberty, laws have to be made by the people. And D, if laws are changed too often, liberty is in danger. Again, it required you to have your basics to be very clear. Let's now come to 2019. 2019 ki agar hum baat kare, toh a lot of questions were solvable by Trigram. If we compare to 2018, it was just a minute easier from 2018, but it was still a tough paper. And in 2019 paper, the importance of Trigram or logic definitely increased, because some 20 to 23 questions were easily solvable using the Trigram method. Also, if we see the 2019 paper, we actually have to say that many questions of polity in history, they looked like a mains question. For example, there was a question asked, which one of the following suggested that governor should be an eminent person from outside the state and should be detached figure without intense political links, or should not have been taken part in politics in the recent past? So technically, it was a question asked on commission. So we learned the lesson from the 2019 exam, that you cannot read any subject in a completely watertight way. It means that earlier people used to read by polity, they are reading for prelims perspective, and polity they will read from mains perspective. In prelims perspective, when they used to read, they used to ignore the recommendations of the commissions. But now that cannot be done, because now there is no clear-cut division what is the polity syllabus and what is the or what is the prelims syllabus and what is the main syllabus. So as we know that last minute revision is a key for clearing this exam, because ultimately, see, you read so many things, unlike your graduation or your master's course where you read only one subject. For example, if I have done my graduation in economics, I was only reading economics throughout the year, and economics was divided into number of subjects. But in UPSC exam, you read everything under the sun. You read polity, you read economics, you read history, you read geography, you read environment, you read science and technology, you read IR, everything under the sun you have to read, which makes it very easier, which makes it very difficult for you to recollect everything in the exam. You might have read everything, but when you sit in the exam, when you see the paper, you would say, okay, I have studied something like this, but I'm not able to recollect. For that, it is required that you do continuous revision of all the subjects. And therefore, this DECIMATE prelims program is all about the revision. We will not teach you anything new. We will ensure that you revise everything in a particular way so that when you go to the exam, you have everything in your mind. So therefore, we are excited to announce the launch of our crash course program, which is DECIMATE Prelims 2020. And the program is designed to give you extensive coverage and the right amount of depth as per the requirement of the prelims exam to help you clear the exam in a very easy way. So as you know that UPSC prelims has become very tricky and unpredictable. And here at CD, we will use all our experience, all our personal experience to ensure that your preparation is in right track, to ensure that you get the right amount of tests, and also you are given right amount or right kind of strategy, which will ensure that you sail this exam as easily as possible. So here is what we are offering in this course. Let me first explain to you the macro elements, and then we will go into the micro elements. So at the macro level, this program contains six main things. One, current affairs lectures from last 2 years, static lectures, current affairs notes, strategy based marks booster lectures, 30 mock tests, and mentorship. These are the six macro elements of this program. Now let's break down it into micro elements. And as we see, this program is divided into three phases. The phase 1 will start from 10th January and it will go on till 15th of February. In this phase will be that it will be the phase of revision. So in this phase, we will give you two, three main things. One, we will provide you online current affairs lectures of from January 2018 till March 2019. And these lectures will be given in following subjects: polity, governance, economics, IR. In IR, we will explain the term in news, the place in news, trade points, choke points, conflict zones, ethnic terms in use. After that, there will be environment, science and tech, and international organization. So technically, why are we teaching past 2 years? The reason being, UPSC has moved beyond ek saal wale jo cheez thi, usse it has moved beyond, because last year, if you see the paper, there was question asked on e-waste management, there was a question asked on solid waste management rules. All of these rules were enacted in 2016. So therefore, it was not in news in last 1 year, but UPSC has been asking a news which was in relevance 2-3 years back. So therefore, we will also include the 2018 current affairs in this program. Second component that we will teach in this phase will be lecture on static subjects. So we will be giving you online lectures on polity, history, geography, economy, arts and culture, environment, and science and technology. And all these lectures will be from prelims point of view, which means we will only tell you those trivias on which a question could be asked in the exam. You might have already read polity, you might have already read history. For example, if you talk of polity, there are a lot of small trivia which you miss while reading Lakshmikant. For example, only in the state of Arunachal Pradesh and Nagaland, governor has a law and order power. So law and order in these states is run by the governor. So these small trivias we will focus in our prelim specific static lecture. Same will go with history, economics, taki when you go to the exam you know ki bhai ye cheeze yahan se question ban sakta hai is chapter mein, and I have to read this chapter thoroughly. Third component in this phase will be mock test. So mock test on basic static subjects. The idea will be that you first read the static part, the static lectures, you watch the static lectures, you read your basic books, after that attempt the static tests. So these static tests will be basic tests on all the basic subjects like history, economics, polity, IR, etc. Fourth will be crisp and updated current affair notes. So these four elements we will give in the first phase of the program. The second phase of the program will start from February 15 and it will continue till 28 April. Now this phase, it will be both offline and online. So there will be lectures in our office, and if you are outside Delhi, you can always watch the online lectures also. So in this phase we will have seven elements. One, current affair lectures from April 2019 to December 2019, and the focus of this lecture will be on following things. One, prelim specific trivia. Secondly, what, when, where, why, how, and thirdly, similar questions asked in last 4 or 5 years. For example, if we are teaching some topic to you and if a similar kind of question was asked in 2017, we will tell you, see, this is an important area and UPSC has been asking questions from this area. Second component will be budget. So there will be 5 hours lecture on the budget, on the budget 2020. Every year one or two questions are also asked from the budget and economic survey. Third and very, very important component of this program will be score boosting prelim strategy lectures by Zeeshan sir. Now I will not explain you more about that, because Zeeshan sir, after me, Zeeshan sir will come and explain what we will do in this score boosting technique lectures, because ultimately this is the main X factor of the program. This program will not just give you content. This program will not just give you test. This program will tell you strategy, how you can score marks in the prelims. Fourth component that we'll do in this phase will be 7 current affairs monthly prelims test from June 2019 to December 2019. The idea behind this current affairs prelims test will be that you watch the current affairs lecture, read the notes, and then after attempt these tests. Fifth component will be samanvay or mentorship. Now this is also which is very important. So we will have a dedicated Telegram group of the students where they can always raise their doubts. Secondly, they can also have a talk on phone with our mentors. Thirdly, they can come to our office and they can have one-to-one personal sessions with our mentors and the faculties. So mentorship is also an important element of this program. We will listen to you. We will, because ultimately in last 2 months, 1 month, lot of people, they have this anxiety factor. So we will always be there to resolve, to slow down, or to ensure that your mind, your body, it remains completely calm and composed. Sixth will be 300 plus schemes which will be discussed in this phase. So we will discuss 300 plus schemes and policies which will ensure that almost all the important schemes of this government will be covered. And lastly, there will be 4 FLT mock tests in this phase. Next we have is phase 3 of our program. Phase 3 of the program will start from 28 April and it will continue till 23rd May. So in this phase, we will give you current affair lectures current affair lecture and notes from January 2020 to April 2020. So last 4 months of current affairs, because ultimately after April, they don't really ask questions from May current affairs. So we will give you lectures and notes from January 2020 to April 2020. After that, the second component will be, there will be more score boosting lectures by Jishan sir. So just before the exam, Jishan sir will again come back and he will again tell you final tips, final strategies which you can use to boost your score. Third will be FLT mock tests. So 4 FLT mock tests which are remaining, you will do in this phase. And fourthly, current affair monthly prelims test from January to April. So these 4 elements are there in the third and the last phase. So this is all about the key components of this program. For more about the strategy based lectures, Jishan sir will now explain and he will explain how and why and what will be the elements of our score boosting lectures. Thank you.
Hello friends, it's great to be before you once again. Sajal sir has already dwelled on important aspects of this program and importance of prelims as well. Now it's my turn to dwell upon my role in this program, in the Decimate prelims program, and its relevance for you as candidates preparing for the prelims 2020 examination. But before we talk about all those big things, before we talk about UPSC, before we talk about the psyche of UPSC, before we talk about the questions framed by UPSC, I believe I must talk about something small first. I believe it is important for me to convey how and why I have developed these techniques over a period of time. And I believe that way you will be able to better appreciate and better relate with these techniques. Just before a few years, a guy from my hometown, my home city, approached me. He approached me and humbly requested me to help him out in prelims. He had been giving prelims for quite some years, but with no success. But when I looked closely, this particular guy, whom I would not name for obvious reasons, he was quite good. He was too good in his mains, as far as his mains answer writing is concerned, as far as his preparation of his optional is concerned, he was too good. But prelims stood as an iron curtain between him and the mains examination hall. So I accepted his request and I started mentoring him, but I put a condition. I said to him that prelims will no longer remain a hurdle for him, but he will have to seize this opportunity and he will have to strive to find his name into the final list. So I fulfilled my commitment. That year he cleared prelims, and also he fulfilled his commitment. He not only cleared the prelims, he cleared mains, he got the call for interview, and eventually he got into the final list, and now he is an IRS officer. So why have I shared this personal example of my life with you? Is it to boast about something that I have done, something very great? Not at all. Please understand, I am sharing this example with you to make you realize that many potential IAS officers, many potential IPS officers, many potential IRS officers are thrown out of the process in the first step itself of the examination, that is the prelims. That is the importance of prelims. So guys, as I have already said, this idea of developing these techniques and consolidating these techniques started taking root in my mind after I mentored this particular friend of mine. And now I am here standing in front of you using the platform of Civils Daily and disseminating this precious knowledge so that those among you who are very much deserving of writing the mains, and not only writing mains but being in the final list, prelims should not be an obstacle for you. prelims should not be a stumbling block for you. So this program, this Decimate prelims program, and especially my lectures, the score booster lectures, hold prominence as far as your preparation for 2020 prelims is concerned. All right, my dear friends, today I won't be explaining any questions to you. I would be just presenting few questions from the past 4 years to you, and I would say you are the best judge to analyze whether these questions or other questions that are framed on these lines by UPSC, are these questions solvable by your knowledge base alone. You are the best judge, and you can analyze it better than anyone else. So just quickly move on with the questions. I'll start with the 2016 questions. The first question is, in the context of developments in bioinformatics, the term transcriptome, sometimes seen in news, refers to. And the correct answer for this question was the full range of mRNA molecules expressed by an organism. So what is the problem in this particular question? The problem in this question is that it has a brutal binary. What I mean is that it is such a question that either you know about it or you don't know about it. And most of the candidates were caught off guard when they tried to attempt this question. So most of the people who attempted this question got it wrong, or many people just left this question. But again, this is easily solvable by using the Tikidam technique. Moving on to the next question from 2016 itself. The question was, what is or are unique about the Kharai camel, a breed found in India? And the options were, it is capable of swimming up to 3 kilometers in seawater. Statement 2, it survives by grazing on mangroves. Statement 3, it lives in the wild and cannot be domesticated. So what is the problem with this question? See, this question was based on current affairs, but it had very specific nuances in it. The question asked very specific nuances that either the civil services aspirants tend to ignore or tend to forget. So again, despite being a question based on current affairs, it was quite difficult to solve this question. But again, it is easily solvable by Tikidam techniques. Moving on to the next question from 2017, and the question was, recognition of prior learning scheme is sometimes mentioned in the news with reference to. And the correct answer was, certifying the skills acquired by trainees under the National Skill Development Program. Alright, what's the issue with this question? The issue with this question is that this particular scheme that has been asked is not a flagship scheme of the government. It is not a prominent scheme of the government, but it is just a peripheral scheme. It is just a sub scheme of a broader, bigger scheme. So we all know that there are n number of such peripheral and smaller schemes, and it is humanly not possible to memorize the mandates of each and every scheme. So again, this particular question is very difficult to solve, but again, it can be easily solved by Tikidam technique. Let's move forward and discuss another question from 2017 itself. The question was, due to some reasons, if there is a huge fall in the population of species of butterflies, what could be its likely consequence or consequences? And the statements that were given were, pollination of some plants could be adversely affected. Statement 2, there could be a drastic increase in the fungal infections of some cultivated plants. Statement 3, it could lead to a fall in the population of species of wasps, spiders and birds. Alright, so my dear friends, what's the problem, what's the issue with this particular question? The issue with this particular question is that it has very unsure statements, very vague statements. The question that is being asked is an impact of loss of a species of butterfly. So there is a very loose link with loss of a species of butterfly and the probable consequences. Even after studying the basic books of environment, and even after following current affairs pertaining to environment, It is very difficult to answer this particular question just based on your knowledge base. But again, it is easily solvable by the Tegedum technique, my dear friends. Let's move on to another question. The question is from 2018 prelims paper, and the question is, which one of the following reflects the most appropriate relationship between law and liberty? And the correct answer was, if there are no laws, there is no liberty. My dear friends, what's the problem with this question? The big problem with this question is that it has a subjective answer. What do I mean? That all the four options provided under this question seemed to be correct. And even when the paper was over, this particular question generated a controversy among candidates and the coaching market in general. For months together, there was no consensus at all regarding what could be the correct answer. Only when UPSC provided the official answer key, then people came to know the correct answer. So, my dear friends, UPSC has been throwing such subjective questions as well in prelims, which is supposed to be an objective paper. Moving on to the next question from 2018 itself. The question is, the staple commodities of exports by the English East India Company from Bengal in the middle of the 18th century were. And the correct answer for this question was cotton, silk, saltpeter and opium. What is the problem with this question? The problem with this question is that it asks something that is too deep. What do I mean? I mean to say that a person need to have too deep a knowledge about modern history to be able to answer this question. And please mind my words, even postgraduates in history found it difficult to answer this question with certainty. Leave the other normal aspirants. Even the PGs in history found it difficult. So, it's quite difficult to solve just based on your knowledge base. But again, it's easily solvable by using Tegedum technique. I have also explained this particular question in one of my earlier lectures that are available on YouTube. Okay, moving forward, coming to the 2019 paper, the latest paper that we have as a reference. And the question is, with reference to land reforms in independent India, which one of the following statements is correct? And the correct answer is, the ceiling laws were aimed at family holdings and not individual holdings. What's the issue with this question? The first issue with this question is that this question is seemingly out of syllabus because it pertains to post-independent history, which is not part of the prelims syllabus. That's one thing. But even after, supposing a candidate has studied post-independent India quite well, even then this question dwells into nuances of this particular aspect of land ceiling law. So even after studying post-Indian history, it is quite difficult to answer this question with 100% certainty. But again, it is easily solvable by using Tegedum techniques, which I have also discussed in one of my freely available lectures. Moving forward, at a question from 2019 paper, the question was, with reference to the cultivation of kharif crops in India in the last 5 years, consider the following statements. There were four statements. Statement 1, area under rice cultivation is the highest. Statement 2, area under cultivation of jawar is more than that of oilseeds. Statement 3, area of cotton cultivation is more than that of sugarcane. And statement 4, area under sugarcane cultivation has steadily decreased. So what is the issue, what is the problem with this particular question, my dear friends? The problem with this question is that the statements are too discrete and too far-fetched. Even if you are following current affairs and even the students of agriculture background found difficult to answer this question with certainty, my dear friends. Because if you look closely, the statements were such that they were too discrete in nature. And as a result, students couldn't pinpoint the correct answer that easily. And such kind of questions also tend to eat up lot of your time in the examination hall. So it's a dual loss for the aspirants. Dual loss in the sense that they might either get this question wrong or they might just leave it. And another loss is that they are losing precious time in the examination hall, my dear friends. All right, my dear friends, unlike my lectures that I had delivered earlier, where I had slowly explained each and every question, I had just browsed this question in a quick fashion in this particular lecture. The motto behind doing this is that I just present to you the inference that when faced with such seemingly impossible questions, Tigram techniques appear to be the only master key to solve such kind of questions. Such kind of questions about which either you have no idea or about which you have just a blur idea, just a little idea, and you are not sure about those questions. But you can arrive at the correct answer with greater confidence, greater certainty. And my dear friends, I would say those people, those aspirants who are privy to these techniques are certainly in a much better position to score good marks in the prelims examination compared to those who are just facing the examination based just on their knowledge base. All right, my dear friends, before concluding my lecture, let me quickly summarize, let me quickly convey that subscribers to the Decimate prelims program, what can they expect from my score booster lectures? So there are a few important things that they can expect are, number one, sharing of advanced techniques to solve seemingly impossible questions and solve those questions about which you have no idea at all. Just as I have said earlier, you will be able to solve seemingly impossible questions, and your strike rate in the main examination will increase as well. Point number two that you can expect from my lectures is that special care will be taken to empower you to practically use these techniques in the examination hall. Yeah, just decimating techniques is a worthless exercise, my dear friends. So I would be taking special care that subscribers of this program are empowered to use these techniques practically into the examination hall and truly maximize their score. So this was point number two. Point number three that you can expect is helping you to increase your risk-taking appetite. Risk-taking appetite, this is a very big problem with students, my dear friends. When it comes to attempting more questions, students just fall behind. Students are very risk-averse because of negative marking. They end up attempting very few number of questions, and thus they are just out of the race because they are very risk averse, and after attempting very few questions, there is no chance that you can find yourself in the list of the prelims result. So increasing your appetite of taking risk is very important, which will be taken care of as part of this lecture. Point number four, removing your fears and apprehensions regarding attempting unknown questions. As I have told earlier, unknown questions are a big problem also. People just tend to panic when they see unknown questions. Unknown questions are those questions which are either out of the syllabus or people have just a blur idea about those aspects being asked in the question. But my dear friends, in general, these questions turn out to be very, very easy. So removing the fear of this unknown question is something very important to help you boost your score in prelims 2020. Point number five, helping you avoid traps set up by UPSC. This is something very important. UPSC has the knack of setting up traps in the questions. So after watching my Tigram lectures, you will be in a better position to spot these traps and avoid them, which will automatically help you increase your score, boost your score. And finally, point number six, my dear friends, helping you spot the many clues UPSC so generally provides. Believe me, my dear friends, UPSC is generous enough to provide hints and clues in many of the questions. But you can only spot those clues, you can only spot those hints if you have that vision, if you have that ability to read between the lines. And my dear friends, as part of my Tikadam lectures, I will be dwelling upon this aspect and I will be empowering you to spot those hints, to spot those clues very generously provided by UPSC and try to maximize your score by that virtue. All right, my dear friends, before ending my lecture, I would like to just tell you one thing. At a time when prelims has been decimating the hopes and hard work of not thousands but lakhs of civil services aspirants, I would ask you to join this offensive of ours where we are trying to decimate the prelims itself. Thank you very much, my dear friends, and take good care of yourselves.
Subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update from Civils Daily.